unfortunately, I brought another one with me. So let's see if this one, we can continue with this one. Okay, once again, we're here with Craig Sawyer. He's with Vets for Child Rescue. And Josh Barnett, he's running for Congress in the state of Arizona. He's helping us to save our children as well. I'll see if I can get him on for a shot. Hey, Craig. Hi, how are you?
Hi.
I know.
What are we doing?
I know you from somewhere.
I'm Trisha.
Okay.
I'm on Facebook.
Hi, Craig. I'm Shannon.
Hi, Shannon.
I'm on Facebook Live right now. Would you like to say hello? Oh, let me turn it around.
For Child Rescue, yes.
Can you tell me a little bit about what you do, Craig?
Yeah, we alert the American populace to the threat of child trafficking with through a lot of means, but primarily through our documentary Contraland, and you can watch it on contralandmovie.com.
I'll post the link later.
And we run operations with federal and local law enforcement arresting child predators. So you can see that on our website, vetsforchildrescue.org.
Thank you for your service.
Thank you, it's a privilege.
Okay, I'm going to go and see if Josh wants to say shout out to anybody. Hi, Josh. I'm on Facebook Live. Do you want to say hi?
What's up, everybody?
Okay.
Get down here if you can. We'll be here till 8.
Okay. Josh, is running for Congress in the state of Arizona, and he's a very good man, so I would definitely give him your support. Can you tell us, Josh, what your platform is here today?
Well, my platform today is we need to fix this issue.
Yes, we do.
And one of the ways to fix the issue is, one simple way is due process back to CPS courts.
Yes.
That is one thing we can do right now.
Jury trials
that can cut the conveyor belt off of kids.
Right.
And that's one thing I want to push today and let people know about it.
This is why we need Josh.
We have legislation that's gone through AZ State Ledge, and none of them have.
Our legislators quit this season, so they're not even talking.
And Marty Lynch is going to be here soon.
Okay, good. I'll go see if I'm looking fine. Thank you, Josh. Okay. All right. So we just spoke with Craig Sawyer with Vets for Child Rescue and Congress. Josh Barnett, who's running for Congress. I'm not sure who else is here that I know personally. I did speak with or message with Priscilla Marquez. So Priscilla, if you're there or here, I'm available if you want to, you know, tell a little bit about your story as well. Another tragic story out of Arizona. I just came up here so possibly we can get a shot of the crowd that's starting to gather, and I want to be able to find a good spot to film when the speakers start, because the messages that the speakers have are absolutely amazing. Yes, Josh is a cutie, isn't he? Yes. Ask Craig Sawyer about Timothy Charles Homestead. You know what? I don't think right now that this is the setting to do that. I can, you know, maybe personally message him about that later, because there has been some discussion about, did Craig Sawyer threaten Timothy Charles Homestead? Well, one thing I want to talk to you about that is, you know, emails can be sent, email addresses can be made up to be sent to a peer, that they are sent from somebody to somebody else. And I'm not saying that's what happened, because I really have no idea what happened, but I don't think that this is really the setting to address that. But I appreciate that you're concerned about that. Let's see, I'm looking at some of the comments here. Thank you for sharing. If you could share to groups, that'd be fantastic, because I'm kind of busy, can't do that right now. So if you could share this to groups for a minute, that'd be great. I will go walk back down around the crowd to get some more shots of the signs, and it might be too loud, so I probably won't be chatting for a minute again. If the video cuts off, it's most likely a technology problem, and I'll try switching back between phones. If my phone overheats, I've brought some ice so I can try to go live again, but my apologies ahead of time if that happens.
like it.
Wait,
I'm not a stranger to you.
The last time we had a rally like this, there was very little news, local news media coverage, which is absolutely disgusting as well, because we all know that the local news, the mainstream media, doesn't address this per agenda. They absolutely refuse. If they do, they spin our stories to make the parents into, you know, monsters. Not all of us are. Yeah, there's a monster or two parent out there. I believe the statistics are 9 out of 10 removals are fraudulent. That means about 90% of the kids that are taken from parents shouldn't be taken. Also, another statistic I've heard, between 60 to 88% of children in the foster custody system do end up being trafficked. So what Josh says is true. It's a pipeline. It's their supply chain, and I've talked about supply chain management in the past as to where they get their products, because for CCS, CPS, children are the products. The funding they receive is amazing. I'm gonna go over here and see what's happening at this booth. Oh, it looks like we can get some. Looks like Phoenix Rising Church came, and they brought some bunches of waters and some treats. Hi, ladies. Can I have a snack? Can I have a snack? Awesome. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. We have a police presence, it looks like. Although the police presence at these events is circling the lot, and they're parked in all their cars, because you never know who's going to show up to cause problems. The group here does not cause problems. We're not here to cause problems. We're here to save the children. It looks like, if you were here at the last rally, the organizer of the event that spoke via teleconference is here today. And this is a man that knows, he's an expert in international child trafficking. He's a big guy in the movement, and I have the utmost respect for what these men are doing. You know, these men have been threatened, they've been harassed, and they don't stop, which is what attitude we should all take. Okay, I'm gonna find a spot. I'll put my snack in my purse for later, so that I don't chew in your ears during this event. I'm gonna pull out my ice pack too, in case my phone's starting to overheat, so I can keep my phone cool. Anybody on here who is saying that this is fake news? I'm not sure why you're here, because there's, you know, if you want fake news, you can go to CNN or mainstream media for this. There's nothing fake about what you're seeing here right now. It's all pretty real. So my position is, you're either on board with child trafficking or you're against it. There's no middle here. You're either going to try to shame and taunt and discredit those of us who have worked for years, day in, day out, to get events like this happening and to get the word out. And so, you know, if you're a troll, it's not going to fly much longer. Trolls you're going to be exposed for the trolls that you are. If you're working for the state right now and you're watching me, which, you know, has been mentioned over and over that my online activity is not helping my case. What is not helping my case, actually, is all the lies that the state is making up and the false charges, and I won't get into all that, but I will tell you that no, I'm not a liar. These people here that you're watching, they're not liars either. So if your intention is to discredit, I'm not even going to bother to comment back in the comments to that. I'll let everybody else take care of you because they're going to shut you down pretty quick anyway. I don't know if this is a news channel video or if it's running. I always like to taunt the media for their non-reporting of issues whenever I get a chance to do that. Okay, it looks like we might be getting started. Oh, maybe not. Another song. They have wonderful music. Missing every year. 1 million kids are sex trafficked in the U.S. 100 million dollars is generated annually from sex trafficking, and 99% are never rescued. Where do these kids come from? Currently in Arizona, I believe the number of children in foster custody sits at around 12,700. Of those, I believe there are around 250 to 300 that are missing. That means they lost 250 kids, which is disturbing in itself. Sometimes these children are found. They're found dead, which is very sad. Children are trafficked for 4 year. The average victim is raped 6,000 times. Every 30 seconds, a child is sold for sex, labor, or organ harvesting. 7 years is the life expectancy for child trafficked victims. Save our children. The numbers are horrendous, but if you really stop and think about it, really, how many is an appropriate amount of children that this is happening to? How many would it be okay that this happened to? Kids don't decide to be prostitutes. They are groomed or forced. Pedophilia is not normal. We will not allow it. Pedos need to keep their eyes and hands off our kids or go find a millstone, because we all know what the biblical punishment for child abuse is. And it involves a millstone, a rope, and the bottom of the ocean. Would you like to say hi? Okay. Hi, everybody. This is my friend Kevin.
Hi.
Kevin was my cab driver one day, and Kevin and I hit it off, and we went out for tacos afterwards. And Kevin's been very supportive of the movement ever since. We're just friends. But anyway, just a shout out from Kevin.
It's time.
It's time. Thank you, Kevin. If you're just joining us, we're in Phoenix, Arizona. We're here with some leaders in the movement nationally, globally, to end sex trafficking. Apparently, we've been loud enough to get the attention of people who understand that the foster care system is a pipeline to human trafficking. And while our governor, I haven't seen him anywhere, and I haven't seen Cindy McCain, nor have I seen Kate Brophy McGee or any other members of the Human Trafficking Council. If you are here, I'd love to see you, and you could, you know, do a little bit on the live with us. That would be fantastic. But so far, I haven't seen any members of our legislature, because while they did quit on us this session and give all the powers to the governor, that's an issue in and of itself. But, you know, the Human Trafficking Council, you would think, would be making an appearance here at this kind of an event, possibly even speaking at this kind of event, to voice their, you know, what are you doing to help? Or how are you profiting? You know, things like that. So, all very interesting. We know you. We see you. We won't stop until every rock is turned over. Thank you. Some of you may know that I have been threatened, intimidated, coerced, and harassed to stop, to shut up, to stop, you know, my voice. Attempts have been made for me to do that myself or to have it done, and I've refused, but I guess this is the lineup of speakers for today. I don't know who these people are, besides Josh. And let me see if maybe I can get one of them to explain to me who they are and why they're here. Let me see. Hi, I'm on Facebook Live. Are you a speaker today? You're shadowing Josh. I gotcha. Hi, I'm on Facebook Live. Are you a speaker here today? Are you a speaker here today? You're not. Okay. I'm trying to get some interviews.
Our daughter is one of the organizers.
Oh, okay. Is there anything you'd like to say on Facebook Live? Or no? Okay, you can just say hi, everybody. Hi, everybody. This is a friend of one of the organizers of the event. I would just like to tell you that you guys do a wonderful job at these events. This is my second one, and the last one was amazing.
This is our first one.
Oh, it is your first one. Okay, well, good job.
Hello, hello, hello. Hey, guys. Okay. No, I'm not up there, but
looks like we're
15 minutes. We're going to get this thing started. We're waiting for there's some more people come in, so we want to let everybody to get here. Really important event with some beautiful speakers today, so be patient, but this is a beautiful time, once again, to get to know your neighbors, take pictures. This event just doesn't happen now. What we take from this is how we change the world for the kids. So get content, take pictures, go live, and make people feel like they're missing out. God bless you guys.
I'm here with Adel Belgied.
Hi guys, how are you?
Hi Adel. I just want to tell you how much I appreciate this personally, and I know my viewers do too. The work that you have done is amazing. I cried my eyes out after the last rally, and I just want to express my complete appreciation. Is there anything like you'd like to say to child safety parent services?
Yes, I think that honestly, you say you appreciate me, and I appreciate you actually more than anything. Because her doing this, what she's doing right now, having you guys on the live, is how we change the children's world.
Awareness.
It's all of us fighting together. It's cool we do these events, but all of you that are at home watching, share, push, help us. Even though you're not here, help us. I mean, these kids need it. These voices are not heard, and it's not a rally that changes it. It's all of us that change it. So thank you for asking me to come
on here. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Hi, would you like to say something to my audience?
Yeah.
I'm on Facebook Live with CPS News Network, and it's Child Parent Safety Network.
Hi, nice to meet everybody.
Hi, who am I here with?
My name is Anessa Perry, and I'm here with Josh Barnett. He's currently running for Congress.
Yes, we brought that up earlier.
Yeah, absolutely. So if you have a vote, if you have a voice, if you want to stop child trafficking, vote for Josh Barnett.
He's the man, I'm telling you. Yes, reaffirm. Thank you so much.
We're having an event on 9/11 as well.
Let me. Go ahead. Start over. Go ahead.
Hi, we are having an event on 9/11 at the University Club on 3rd Street in McDowell. If you would like to attend and talk about the topics that affect Arizona, that affect District 7, that affect the Capitol, that affect children, you'll come. Contact me. My name is Anessa Perry.
Right on. We can share that link if you send that link as well. Tell Josh and he can get it to me. I appreciate it. Do you have some? Perfect. Josh Barnett for AZ. Awesome. Okay. See who else we can get. I don't want to just butt in. I mean, I will eventually, but I do have a little bit of decorum. Okay, me too. By spreading the news.
Excuse me.
Which is Child Parent Safety News. And I'm wondering if you could introduce yourself and say hi to our people.
Guys, I'm actually a speaker at the event. I'm Yako Boyance. I'm not an organizer, but thank you for fighting so hard for the children. We appreciate
it. Awesome. Thank you so much.
Yako, I'm sorry.
Okay, back to you.
Eventually, I'll, you know, get links and names up for everything that I videoed, but right now we're just enjoying the crowd starting to get bigger. Okay, I'm going to walk up the steps again so that I can get a little bit away from the sound. Maybe some more signs. Love the bullhorn, love the bullhorn. Louder, louder.
Sounds like.
Okay, I think I'm gonna try to jump up onto this. Nope, I'm gonna walk around because I'm over 50. Probably shouldn't be trying to jump up on anything over 50. Okay, safely, Henderson. Safely. All right. Trying to get up here somewhere where I can view the screen. I don't know. Excuse me, pardon me. I'm going to try to get over here so I can find a spot. Wow, those things are sharp. I know that. I live in Arizona. Okay. All right. Nor do I want to drop down there. Hi! Shut down CPS. I agree completely. Shut down CPS. Save our children. Okay, so it looks like I got a pretty good spot right here. As long as I don't step to the right or to the back and fall off. These things happen. Although, can't really see the screen. I know you can see you'll be able to see the speakers pretty well. But, I don't know, we'll try this out. Maybe I'll head back over there. I don't like this from the side stuff. Plus, this plant's sharp. Okay, one more time, guys. Sorry. That wasn't my spot. That wasn't my spot.
Right in the sun.
Great. Hi there.
Hi.
Okay.
Oops. Sorry.
Hey, this looks like a really good spot right here. Hey, we probably have about 10 more minutes before the speaker starts, so I'm gonna put my ice pack out again and make sure my phone's not too hot. And I'm gonna look through the comments.
I forgot your name.
I'm Shannon.
Shannon, do you have a card?
I don't have a card, but I'm all over Facebook. It's CBS News Network.
CBS News Network.
Yeah, if you just type in CBS News Network, you'll be able to find us. In fact, you'll probably see us live. P.S.
What?
CPS.
Oh, CPS.
Yes, it's Child Parent Safety News Network right there. Yep. That's my Arizona page. There's also a national page, and the national page is the one that we're on live right now. So if you go to the national one, yeah, right there. That's it. You probably, yep, there's us right there.
Awesome. Yeah.
And that's where I'm streaming live right now.
Yeah. Can I give you one of these to take with you?
Absolutely. Yep. Yep. I can make copies. I've been helping to promote him as well.
Thank you.
Yep.
Shannon,
if there's anything else I can do.
Shannon Henderson.
Henderson. Yes. Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so I probably have the best spot in the place. So I guess I'll just stand here. I do need to check my battery power and see how my battery is doing. I'm good on battery. Okay.
I'm the whole cap tumbling down the city that we love. Great clouds all over the hills raining down on this world. But if you lose your eyes.
Oh, and there's Roosevelt. Roosevelt sang at the last rally, and so I have a funny that Roosevelt is going to sing again. You can find Roosevelt at Roosevelt Sings, I think, on Instagram.
All right.
She's the girl with the bun. And here we go. Okay.
Bennett, you're not going on the stage, okay?
If my audio or my video cuts off, I will come back on. It means my battery died or my phone got too hot, but I have backup, so if you lose me, be patient. I'll be back. I'm gonna look at some of the comments while we're waiting. Yes, New Jersey, they're doing the same thing in New Jersey. Okay, here we
go. That's what's happening. Oh, that was good. You're warming up, I know. We're going to get loud like we did last time. We're going to be louder today. All right, we're going to be louder than we had last time. It's about half what we had, but I'll tell you what, we're going to be louder. So, Phoenix, what's happening? Are you guys ready to get loud for the kids tonight?
Please share out to group.
Who's been down the rabbit hole the past couple weeks since the last event? It's a pretty draining thing, isn't it? But, It's draining, but at the end of the day, we're all out here for the right reason. It's to be here for the kids. So I want us all to remember that going forward. Hey, guys, do me a favor. From this left side, let's get like a big shift, a tiny bit. Just let's come this way. Photo ops will look good, better like that one. Just saying. Learn from the president himself. I like you, buddy. Awesome. Well, hey, thanks, guys. Thanks for showing up today. Many of you, I know we're here for our July 31st event. Absolutely amazing. I told you we're going to be back again, and we are here back again, and it's not without you guys. So thank you for being here. Please give yourself a round of applause for being here. This is a moment in history, and you have to remember that. This is how things change. These times, these moments, this effort, this energy. And I know, trust me, I know a lot of you didn't sleep last night. And I know a lot of you are drained. And a lot of you are at a point where like, what can I do? And please, God, give me the light and show me the way and give me the answer. And trust me, You look around, and I bet you 85% at least of people around here are saying the same thing. So here we are together. This is a big therapy session for us to go forward, okay? So we're going to have a good night tonight. A few things I want to start with you guys. I'm going to be hosting the event tonight. We are blessed to have beautiful, amazing speakers that have been fighting fights for a very long time. A very educational movement. And I think that's one of the most important things going forward here, guys, is look, marches are amazing, and we're going to finish off around the Capitol here tonight. But the education that we take from this and we go forward with is what it's all about. It's not just going down the street and yelling, which is great, and you know, you cause awareness, but it's also the education that we have. Because I'll tell you what, a lot of this starts from home. And a lot of it can be prevented from home. So when you ask yourself what you're doing and what should I do, ask yourself if you're doing enough in your home, okay? A couple of rules we wanted to set. We did an amazing time last time setting up, cleaning up the grounds. Guys, actually was immaculate. I walked out of here and I was beyond amazed. I mean, yeah, it's kudos to you guys. A lot of the people that are coming back today and the speakers that came are because of that. I mean, there wasn't one piece of trash. So please respect your environment, respect your area, respect the land that you live in. This is America. We're blessed to be here, so please respect that. Another point to bring up, this is the boring part, guys. I'm here lecturing, so take it as this is the most boring part. Another point to bring up is that there's no agenda here, guys. There's no agenda with any alignment, organization, march. And what I'm pointing towards is we're not conspiracy theorists. This isn't, and I say this respectfully, but this is no QAnon movement. This is all off of facts, research, and what's really happening, and we're bringing it to light. Okay, you can name it whatever you want to name it, but at the end of the day, we're fighting for the kids. So there's no Democrat, there's no Republican. We're only going to work with people that want to work with us. Simple as that. And I promise you, we keep going, and a lot of people are going to want to work with us.
I'm trying to plug my battery in.
With that being said, I said it when I got up here earlier. Your biggest part here going forward is your social media. Okay, we're going to get into this a little bit later on, is that we call it digital wars, and I actually had a gentleman over here for V4C from Craig Sawyer's organization. He mentioned that. He said, you know, I'm a digital warrior. I said, man, you're the warrior of today, because that's what it is. So all of you out here, you're warriors, you're God's warriors, you're whatever you want to call yourself, but you're warriors. So with that being said, I want you all to go live. Don't be shy. Stay live the whole time. Drain your battery. That guy's live back there. I love it. There he is. You know, keep your signs going. Take pictures with people. It's the content we take from this and move forward with is going to help change the world. And believe it or not, it was one post that when we had a couple hundred people show up at the Capitol a month and a half ago, when God said to me at 2 a.m. one night, he said, go march. I knew this. I was enlightened about it. I was woke. But he said, go march. And we had 200 people show up. Then we brought 2,300 out 2 weeks after. And here we are again today. And you know, it's really just understanding that we need to move forward on the right point, but we can all do this together. We can move forward. We have to unite. Anything is possible. The last thing I want to top off here is we're going to march at the end. Make sure to keep that peaceful. I've already stated that. That's something I want to clarify. We're here to work with the police. We have security here. Everything's going to be protected. We're all good. But please, a round of applause for the security and the people that are here to help us. Look, at the end of the day, I believe in security, and I believe in law enforcement. So we're blessed to have the enforcement here. So please say your thank yous. So with that, guys, we are excited because today we have a packed lineup. We have one of the most amazing singers I think I've ever heard sing the national anthem. She's a detective from the Surprise Police Department on the Child Sex Trafficking Unit. She has a couple million views on YouTube. Tanya Keplinger, she's the woman, the myth, the legend. Please welcome Tanya to the stage as she sings our national anthem.
Oh.
broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. On the ramparts we watch, we're so gallantly streaming, and the rockets ring clear, the bombs burst.
You guys see what I'm saying there? What a voice. God bless you. God, thank you for serving, Tanya. We appreciate you. Thank you for everything you do. When you talk about somebody that's in the trenches that has to see it before their eyes, that fights the fight, that she took her time and said, hey, I'm off today. Would you like me to be in uniform? I'll tell you what. When you want to talk about defund, I talk about fun people like that, okay? I talk about bring them to life. Because that's the light that I want to see. That's God's light. So thank you once again. We appreciate you. So I want to talk about going back to the marches and how this has become, guys. This has been an adventure, and it's exciting. And it, like we said, it's getting started. This isn't the last one again. We're going to come back here again, and we're going to move, okay? And it was about a month and a half ago when we started the marches and when we gathered, and more people started coming, and they started getting into it. And I'll tell you what, like I said last time, Phoenix, we had the first march in the nation that I saw go up. So I owe it to you guys. I saw you guys. Give yourselves a round of applause. Guys, louder, louder. That's it. We're not... The 18-hour days for 2 months straight. We better get some energy going because we're going to work. So the beautiful thing is after the last event, I was approached by who's become a very close friend of mine very quick. And it's funny how God aligns you with the people. He's, you know, they say search and they said pray. And you know, sometimes you pray and you're like, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? And these people come into your life and you know when it happens. You become enlightened. And I had a gentleman by the name of Travis Haley. He approached me and he said, Adel, I want to be a part of what you're doing. And a lot of you have. And me and Travis followed up with up on that. And guys, I'm here to tell you that we're going to make some amazing things happen. Like, this is the beginning. These rallies, these marches, it's going to get started. We're talking about doing things. We've already talked with the Scottsdale PD, just giving you some FYI on some stuff. We've talked with them on how to catch pedophiles and setting things up and local organizations, exposing. Look, at the end of the day, we're here to bring enlightenment and light to what's happening.
Okay? Why isn't our state government doing this?
There's no set
answer. Why isn't our state government doing this?
On what to do, it's to do your job and to do your part.
Why aren't Doug Ducey and Cindy McCain doing this?
With Travis, we came up with, and his girlfriend Bertoni and my girlfriend Iwana, we came up with We Care, Warriors Ending Child Abuse, Rape, and Exploitation. Come on, louder, guys. Hey, if we don't support each other, who's going to support us? You know? It's not a hoorah, hooray. This is all love for everybody. So we came up with We Care, and we're looking at this, and I want you guys, my point of sharing this with you guys, I want you guys to stay in touch with me. A lot of you have been reaching out. It's been a lot. But we're excited to start creating chapters. We're excited to start creating divisions, and we're excited to create a movement going forward to where We Care represents the community here in Phoenix, because there is a large community here in Phoenix. And guys, let me tell you, this is one of the largest playgrounds for them pedophiles, and I'm ready to end it.
Where's our governor? Billions in federal funding to end this. Where's our governor?
So I want to bring up to the stage a gal who had this event, Where Are Our Children? They had to set this up to march here in Phoenix on the same day. We had connected, we combined, we talked, and we said, let's organize and let's make something beautiful happen, and here we are. So we made things happen in the past week, and guys, that's what it's all about. It's not about an ego here of anybody. This isn't anybody just win. This is for the kids to win. This is where we put our egos aside. This is where it's not that you won today, it's that the kid that you fought for won today, okay? So it's my pleasure to introduce up here Chris Guglielmo, and she's gonna kick my butt for her last name, but Chris Guglielmo and her crew from Streetlights. And they want to come up here and give you a brief rundown of what they're doing. If you guys would welcome to stage Chris Guglielmo, Sharon Johnson, Adela Cano.
Hey guys, my name is Christina Guglielmo. Thank you all for being here to fight the fight. There's no bigger fight than the one we're fighting right now for our children. Sorry. I may be like some of you. I knew child trafficking existed, but until quarantine, when I had a lot of time to research, I sadly have found out how severe it is. And now I cannot sleep at night. My heart hurts. I want to know where all our 800,000 children that go missing per year just in this country are. A child is sold every 30 seconds. Right now, this very second, a child is being sold. I have five amazing children. I want to make this world a better and safer place for them. I am their biggest fan and advocate. I don't want to look at them and tell them why mommy knew this was going on and remained silent. Our silence is their consent. I know a lot of people that remain silent, and I ask myself why. Is it too much for them to handle? But we have to think about this as a cancer or diabetes or heart disease. What do we do to be proactive? We work out, we eat healthy, we don't smoke, we wear our sunscreen. We need to start being proactive regarding child trafficking. We don't wait for our children to be kidnapped to start getting loud. Woo! If we all don't unite to fight, it's only a matter of time before they come for my kids, for your kids, your brothers, or your sister's kids. The media remains silent because they want to keep us divided. This is one thing that can bring us all together. A child doesn't care what race you are or who you're voting for. They just want to be saved. We need to be a voice for the voiceless. We need to start being more observant of our surroundings for our own children as well as others. When we are out, we see a single mom getting her kids in the car. We need to be their eyes when they are too occupied to see. We need to be aware of signs to look for to help children that could be in danger. When you think your voice doesn't matter, look around. All these people here tonight were brought together by a few voices.
Whoever just said that about Clinton not being the guy that started this, that's bullshit.
What we can do
Bill Clinton
if we
started
all
ass
get
with.
Loud together
Go away.
To save our children. Now I want to welcome Sharon from Streetlights, and Adela Cano.
Inform yourself. This started with Bill Clinton, ASFA, 1997. Don't debate me on that one.
All right. Thank you so much. Like Chris said, my name is Sharon Johnson. I have the privilege of working with an organization called Streetlight USA. Thank you. Streetlight USA, we work as a residential facility here in Phoenix. We operate nationally. We take girls from all over the United States that have been victims of sex trafficking. We've been around for about 10 years. We started because concerned citizens got wind of a trafficking issue in their neighborhood in the West Valley and said, no, that can't really be true. Did a little research and discovered it was true. And 10 years ago, the climate While it wasn't as publicized, trafficking was still happening in our neighborhoods. It was happening in suburban neighborhoods. It was happening in urban neighborhoods. It was hitting every demographic. And out of those concerned citizens who walked away from research and said, we can't be silent, they joined forces, and a group of 14 churches came together and formed.
Duh, it's still happening. Can you see what we're doing? We're trying to stop it from happening. Yeah, it's happening. Trump shut down CPS.
Took in our first girl under our license. We've had over 1,300 girls come through our program. We could not do this work if it were not for concerned citizens, people hearing, but most importantly, taking action. Taking action, absolutely. We are proud, proud citizens of Arizona.
If you're going to blame anybody, blame your governors. They're the ones that are taking your kids.
10 years ago, if a girl was picked up, if a 12-year-old was picked up in a situation with an adult man, she was arrested. She was prosecuted for prostitution. And the gentleman, if he said, I didn't know that she was 18, he was let off, or she was under 18, he was let off on what was called the John Law. That is not the case today. We are prosecuting, yes. We are understanding, communicating, and speaking on behalf of children that data consent does not exist for children. Child prostitution is not a thing. Trafficking is what is happening, and anytime that a child is being asked to conduct a sexual activity in exchange for their livelihood, food, shelter, clothing, safety, that is trafficking. So, Streetlight, where the pieces began to get put back together after. So we need warriors like you being vigilant to help us decrease the issue. We need rescuers. We need partnerships with law enforcement, our national. We need partnerships with our legislature so that laws get changed, that punishments are present where they weren't before. We cannot do this alone. And we bring those girls in and we pick up pieces and help them see that there is hope. So our tagline at Streetlight USA is trauma to triumph, hope to healing. So while we may sit in the work that I do with our team at Streetlight on a different side of the activity, we cannot do the work. We cannot see hope. We cannot see healing without partners like you all. So please stay vigilant in paying attention, in speaking up, in speaking out, in being a voice for the vulnerable population. Trafficking is real. The reality of trafficking and the devastation of trauma to these children is real, but hope is real too. And that's our message. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you for coming out. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to share a little bit about Streetlight. I'm going to be kind of right down here for a little while with some more information. But again, thank you so much for all that you guys are doing. We really appreciate the work you're doing here.
Hi, my name is Adela Cano and I'm here. I joined these wonderful ladies because there was just so many different stories going around, and especially with during quarantine. It came across my attention when it's a sore topic for everybody to hear about, and it's about those babies in the cages. It's about babies everywhere. And the thing is people forget they're babies. Whether their parents try to bring them over, they didn't try to bring them over, they're going missing. And there, one mom, I had heard her story, and she was like, they got us. What happened was, I never heard about my baby again. I've asked, and they can't find where my baby's at. They don't know where they placed my baby. Imagine if that was your child. Not knowing where your child is at and what is being done to your child. That is why I am here right now making a voice. Not just for the kids here, but for the kids everywhere. And we need to stick together and make sure that they come home safe. Thank you.
name's Rachel. I'm with Where's Our Children as well, and we are super, super excited for everyone, all the love, all the support. We were blessed, as Adele said, right? God does amazing things. God does amazing things. A few weeks ago, it was put on my heart. This is something I've been talking about since my mid-20s, with groups of friends, the things that go on. And a couple weeks ago, I got to the point where I was like, all right, God, how can I be of maximum service to you and to others? Like, I'm tired of talking about it, I'm ready to be about it. Like, who else is ready to be about it? I wanted to come up here and just thank everyone. I'm grateful for Adele, for We Care, for everything God has brought, people God has just dropped, like Adele said, in my life over and over. And it's beautiful and incredible. And the fact that we can all, as warriors of the light, come together for our kid and raise up and get our voices heard. There are so many people who have put so many hours of work into this, and I just wanted to thank people, everyone who's just taken the time out of their day, to Phoenix Rising Church and the Thornberry family, who have provided us free water. So if anyone didn't know that, it is free. Please go there, hydrate yourselves. Phoenix summers, it's important. But just thank you all again so much for being here, and let's just, as Adele said, keep on coming. One thing we had talked about with Where's Our Children, we don't want this to be a once-a-year thing where people get fired up, talk about child sex trafficking, and then have the fire die off. This isn't something that can die off. This is something that is huge. This is something that is massive, that goes beyond Republican, Democrat, party lines, spiritual lines. Just coming together as one. So please, next time, share the events. Invite your friends, invite your family, just spread the message. Let everyone know, because this is a huge issue that people don't want to talk about because it's dark, but the only way to stomp out that darkness is for everyone here to bring in the light. So thank you so much for being here.
Oh, and I'd like to thank all the media that's here, which I don't see any of it.
Child Parent Safety Network, share it out. We're here. Where's our governor? Where's Cindy McCain? Where's the Human Trafficking Council?
All right, we'll get into that quickly here. Everything good, JD? Okay, thank you. Thank you guys for coming up here. Once again, thank you for organizing everything, getting the permit set up and everything like that. You guys have been working diligently, so everybody you guys just saw up there, one more round of applause for them. Thank you for everything you guys are doing. So, fake news. Let's get started.
Woohoo!
Hold on a second. Hold on. Where's it at? Somebody gave me this earlier. It's the only mask I will wear. It says no fake news. But, you know, I will say this. Look, we had an interesting situation happen last time where, and we'll say this loud and proud. Actually, you know what? I want you guys to do me a favor, because we're going to get very interesting here. We're going to get some very world-renowned speakers coming up. People that have taken time out of their day. Honestly, they get paid a lot of money to speak at different places, and they've chosen to be here with us, which is very powerful. I need you all to get your phones out. I mean, everybody get your phones out. I know, I'm pushing you here. I want everybody to go live on your Facebook, your Instagram, because we're going to be the news.
We are the news now.
By the time we walk out of here, we're going to have drained batteries, so we'll all be on the
local
same page.
Local media,
we'll
you suck.
We have enough studs in the arena. So, I will give it, here's what happened. When we left the last rally, we had, I'll even say for what it is,
Linda
CBS News, AZ Family.
Whoever you are, get off my feed. I don't care if you don't think it's true
event.
Or not. Go away.
Drone footage.
You're obviously a state agent or a troll or a psychopath. Go away.
Weird. Look, at the end of the day, we're not fighting. We're not going to fight anybody.
I'm reading some comments.
You
know, I see some ass white comments.
So now that's where we got to understand our job to be the warriors we need to be, because you are the news. Understand that. And I'm looking around the I see mothers, and I see fathers, and I see brothers and sisters. Let me ask you this. How many of you have been affected or know somebody that's been affected by either being raped as a child, sexually trafficked, abused, exploited, murdered? How many of you guys know that? Wow, so I see maybe it's 85% of the event here. Guess what? All 100% of you, if you actually got to know the people that you know, all 100% of you will be raising your hand. That's how powerful this is. That's how many people this is affecting. And I know I told you guys last March, it was 2 days before we started the last event, my nephew was exploited, and I got naked pictures sent to me and saying, hey, send us some money or we're gonna upload this to YouTube. And I said, excuse me, you understand that's child pornography. Like, you cannot do that, he's 15 years old. And they said, good luck, I'm with an organization. And that's all the guy said. He said, send the money. I tell you, I'd love for that Bubba to come meet me up. He's welcome to come meet me. And I told him, I said, hey, you're welcome, pick a place and time. He didn't want to pick a place and a time. But that's not what it's about. What we're here to do is expose and bring people to light. So guys, it's my honor to bring up one of the most world-renowned people.
When I know, isn't to, that probably the cutest thing?
When it comes to special ops, when it comes to somebody that served our country. Travis was a Force Marine Recon Marine with multiple combat.
Well, I know it's happening. Iraq, it's happening
Africa,
to my child.
In Afghanistan. He's best known for his actions as a Blackwater private military contractor during combat operations in Al Najaf, Iraq, where as a sniper, he and his team held off hundreds of enemy insurgents in a two-day firefight. What a stud. Guys, like, the people I'm introducing up today, I'm just like, I don't even, it's like, it kills me. I'm like, what did I do?
You're here.
Since he departed from the military and contract world, Travis has worked as a law enforcement officer and achieved numerous accolades in the private sector. And is America's top weapons, tactics, and mine architect trainers and product developers for the military, law enforcement, and responsible citizens. He now serves as CEO of Haley Strategic Partners right here in Scottsdale. And he also serves as my partner in We Care. Please welcome Travis Haley to the stage.
I loved and hated every second of it, right? No, thank you very much for coming. This is amazing, guys. I mean, what's awesome about this is seeing all the faces out here, seeing everybody from completely different pathways of life come together and have the same conclusion about the same cause. And I was you 3 weeks ago, right? When I was here with Adel last time, I didn't know Adel. I've never met him before. And I came up and I felt the energy. I felt the desire to do something about it, which I've been exposed to the human trafficking world numerous times in my career. But unfortunately, it was collateral damage to me, right? It's not my mission at that point in time. And now I look back and go, my God, was it worth it? And it is. It is now. And I realize that my life is designed and I've created a very special skill to help with what we're about to fight for right now. So again, thank you for everybody for coming. This is not easy for us to do in today's climate, right? It's especially in the hole. What I mean by the hole is the whole, the world, the 8 billion, right? Or whatever number we're almost at right now, the 8 billion people. So that's the whole. We love the whole, right? Because we find family, we find love, peace, community, tribe, team, the balance of opposites every day that we walk that line, you know, the smiles and cries of life. You've got the everything associated with happiness, love, peace, winning, success. And I could go on for thousands of words, right? And then everything on the other side of that, the cry side is pain, agony, failure, misery, defeat, and even death. Because somebody once told me on my team when we were in a pretty bad situation, he said, when everybody was stressing out, hey, Travis, nobody gets off this spaceship alive. And so, and I want to remind you of that. You want to be to your fullest. You want to realize that you can go just like that. Your children can go just like that. I've seen it firsthand. And so I want to talk about something here, though, that is the warrior concept, right? So we are warriors. And a lot of people would typically look at a warrior and say, well, you got to have a bunch of gear on and go overseas and put foot to ash for your country or be like these law enforcement officers here that are protecting us and serving our communities today. It's not true. You know, like Adel said, you guys are warriors right now if you're holding your phones up. You're warriors right now just for being here, okay? You're warriors right now. I mean, again, I want to see the raise of hands because I didn't see it, but how many people have been affected by this subject in some way, shape, or form? Every one of you are warriors, right? Because you're not a victim of life. You're a beneficiary to it. So what do you do with that now? I know what I'm doing with it. I know what these gentlemen and ladies are doing here. And I want to talk about some of the climate that we've experienced recently. And I've seen, it's very frustrating, the conformed warrior. Now, if you know me, I would never put those two words in the same sentence, conforming and warrior.
Oh my gosh, okay? Look, the fake news
We were working with
that.
Some local officials here recently, law enforcement them. Officials, not in this city, but other cities. And
Panaway.
And I said, hey, here's this current situation, what's going on in the world, and we all agreed. And he said, well, you know what, Travis, just sometimes we have to conform to it, and this is our new normal. Last time I checked, breathing my own bile through a mask, even if it's cool or not, right, is not our new normal. My kids are sitting at home on the internet all day, and they don't even get to see their teachers. They don't get to see their friends. They're scared because of people out there, organizations out there, that are exacerbating your fears and uncertainty.
Our governor!
And then handing you a silver platter with an enemy on it and saying, they did this to us, go fight.
Our governor!
Right? And that's a lot of it creates ignorance. And so, because we don't know, when you have a lack of knowledge, we teach about knowledge is the number one aspect to your intellect, right? It makes you make better decisions in your life. So, with that, this warrior concept says, well, one of the things that I was put on this planet to do is create a warrior ethos. And I'm like, interesting. Okay. I'm all about it. Here, let me know all about it. He said, well, we want our officers to go out and have this tribal feeling, this security, this camaraderie, and know that they're supported as warriors. Well, he goes, I was saddened, though, because my local politicians and concerned that the it was intimidating, and that it put off the improper psychological mindset because it was a military institutionalized word. And I said, so what did you do? He said, we changed it to the word guardians. And I was like, so okay, here's an example. If I gave you $100 right now and you gave me $100, what did we just do? We just traded money, right? We didn't win. So we were just trading words, because guess what a guardian is? It's also a warrior. Okay, but it's a little bit better word to say there. So with that, I said, well, why didn't you just simply educate the community and your politicians? So coming back full circle on this, I'm going to ask you exactly what I asked them. What do you think is the number one attribute or key ingredient to a warrior? What's the number one thing you have to have before anything else? Anybody? Yell it out.
Courage.
Okay, awesome. I hear some great answers. Empathy, courage, heart, right? So what's another word for heart?
Love.
Compassion. You have to have compassion. That's something I didn't realize until the later years of my operational life in the military, is that when I say that to people, they look back at me with this deer in the headlights look. And they're like, well, what does compassion have to do with being a warrior? It has everything to do with being a warrior, because the more you care about something, the harder you fight for.
Yeah.
Just like our freedom, our constitutional rights, our children. Okay. I think in closing on that subject, when you become a part of the whole, you have to remember not to forget to be your true, unique, fundamental self. Because when you do that, you can get heard that terminology before, bamboozled. Now, whether you love him or hate him, Carlson, the great theory is that when you have been bamboozled long enough, you will reject any evidence. What do you think is happening right now?
We've been bamboozled.
News crews here?
We've been bamboozled.
Why do you think you're the news now? So, anymore. And so with that,
bamboozler. Looks
so
like
with that, objective truth is what I look at. I don't put my personal truths, my political truths, my religious truths,
or anything inside. I bet you're not going to see it though on any local channel. And if you are, we're going
to
be called some names out here.
Possibly can. So please keep doing that.
See how he pan away.
You will see the benefits from it.
Calling them out.
I want to give you an example of this warrior concept, because I want I go into a military special operations unit right now and ask them, and I train those guys all the time, and I'll say, what's the number one ingredient to a warrior's mindset, blah, 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 and they spew from the mouth. I say the word compassion. Why is it so hard to be vulnerable in today's world? The compassion for yourself, the compassion for others, and then the courage to be imperfect. Every one of you that raised your hand is vulnerable, which means you're also a warrior because you're compassionate. So thank you for being that. I want to give you an example, like one of the ladies gave earlier. What if somebody took your child? What if somebody came in your house tonight?
They did.
And tried to hurt you or hurt somebody else? What would you do to that person? I thought I was bad. Good question. What else would we do, right? Because when seconds count, cops are only minutes away, and every good cop and law enforcement officer are your guardian for your home, for yourself, for your children. So with that, if somebody tried to take your child or hurt you, and you did unspeakable things to them, which I probably would do, and again, I'm tired of fighting. I don't want to hurt anybody, right? But if you touch the most precious thing in the world to me, bad things will probably happen. So what I want you to understand about that is not the bad deed. It's why did I do it? Did I do it because of that person's evil motive or intent?
DCS takes more kids than anybody else.
Or did I do it because I care about something so much more precious? That's what I want you to understand about that. Okay. This is something I didn't realize in my career. I thought that it was all charge ahead.
I
didn't realize that my heart was come on
until I get my kid back.
And then connecting that with this,
throw away
you're
the key.
Able to do amazing things.
Pry my phone from my cold dead hand.
So don't conform, is my point. Don't conform to the BS. Don't conform to the bamboozle. Continue to educate yourselves. And you know, I've seen
Kimberly,
a lot of wonderful things in my
I'm
life.
I'm sorry,
I've seen a lot
it's
of
a horrible feed. Then the
I used to live by Thomas Paine's quote.
It is what it is. I'm not the
real
news.
If there's
going to
be trouble, let
it's
it be now
news.
In my time, so that in the future my children will be safe.
Yes.
And I'm 17 years old. I'm joining the Marine Corps. That's where I went. I had an awesome opportunity to have a full football scholarship to the University of Florida, and then I said, no, I want to serve my country. I want to put foot to ass for my country. And I did. And I lived by that quote. I lived by that quote. And then I started to wonder, you know, I come from 8 generations that I know of gunfighters, of warriors, all the way back to the American Revolutionary War. As a matter of fact, my 8th generation served as a private under his son, 7th grandfather, because he had to come out of retirement to fight in 1776 in the American Revolutionary War. He said, Dad, you got to get up, got to fight, and he did. And then every major conflict till today, we've been in the Haley family. And my brother's a colonel in the Marine Corps right now. And what scares the hell out of me, I've got a 13 and a 15 and other kids that I've brought on with my lovely Queen Bertoni, and we have 7 kids now. So I'm invested in this. My kids and saying, well, do I want them to see what I've seen? And I look at them, I go, you know what to do, right? But no, I was bad. But seriously, you know, it's about that quote. I wonder, and the point of 8 generations of warrior, did my father say the same thing that Thomas Paine said? Did his father say that? Did my 8th generation grandfather say that, hey, if there's going to be trouble, let it be now my time so that in the future my children will be safe? I think we've realized that we'll never be safe. It's a beautiful, wonderful world. The problem is the bad is simply louder. Would you agree with that or not?
Yeah.
So let's...
Thank you, John, for liking my feed.
Let's make it good times, right? And let's be strong because we know strong men and women create good times. But we also know that good times create weak men and women. And then we also know that weak people creating those bad times, right? That's how it perpetuates. And then guess where we are right now? I think we're at the point on that line where we're about to step into that next cycle. to bring strong people back and create good times again.
Travis Haley, 2024.
I don't know if you want me to be the president, huh? So guys, I'm going to leave you with this. Again, that if everybody on this planet for one day, just one day, woke up and was impeccable with their words and their actions, their voice, they didn't take things personal, they stopped making assumptions about themselves or other groups or other people or other subjects like this constantly happening in today's world, and if they simply just woke up and when they planted their feet on the ground, they took a step up the ladder of excellence.
Thank you, Sherry.
Those four things. Imagine
that. Thank you for the
thank you. Fantasy world. If everybody did those four things in one day, what would the world be like? You're doing it right now, and I appreciate you. I really do. I'm not going to sit up here and keep running my mouth. I want to get onto these awesome speakers, guys. But speaking of good times, good things, and awesome and amazing people, I'm going to introduce my next speaker up here, and that's Craig Sawyer. Now, Craig, as you, I'm sure, know, has an incredible career. He's done amazing things for our country and as well for this community here and what we're fighting for. And Craig started as a United States Marine and then transitioned to the Navy to get into the Navy SEAL teams. We won't hold it against him, though, because once a Marine, always a Marine. He'll admit that. But then he went on after serving in the teams, and he got selected to the Naval Special Warfare Development Group we call DEVGRU, or SEAL Team 6. He's also been a federal law enforcement agent and founded a nonprofit organization, Veterans for Child Rescue, and also known as V4CR. And Craig will tell you a story, but he did that to expose these traffickers, to expose these pedophiles, and create what we call in the military a non-permissive environment for these people, right? I want you to think about something, actually, I didn't say earlier. Have you looked around tonight and noticed that if there's any pedophiles here? Well, that was an interesting physiology change, right? Because you know that. It could be your next door neighbor, it could be pedophiles, and we have to create a non-permissive environment. And yes, they come to events like this because criminals like to come to events to see how we can catch them. And trust me, guys, if you are in this crowd,
like the fake news,
we have a very specific set of skills, and you'll never identify how we're going to catch you. Trust me.
Interested in doing a lot of film.
And thank you guys for helping us create that non-permissive environment. Now, with V4CR's first documentary, we want to show you a trailer here in just a second, Contraland. I'm sure you guys have seen it. If you have not, it's absolutely amazing. It's recently aired over 90 million households on the Daystar Television Network. And you guys can go to ContralandMovie.com and watch it for free right now. And I highly suggest you do it. It's an amazing documentary that Craig and his team put together. And what I'd like to do right now, guys, is show you his trailer and his empowering expose. Thank you very much.
There are about 75 cartel organizations that are controlling and trafficking women and children. Now, this is slavery. These children come from our families. It's evil.
I don't ever feel like I'm going to be the same. I feel marked.
How much is two girls for a half hour?
I really wanted my mom to love me. And I also didn't want her to be sick.
I'll do it for $150.
It's so common that no matter what town you're in, you could probably go within a couple blocks and find a victim or a perpetrator of child trafficking.
Hi, how are you? Very nice to meet you.
The sexual exploitation of children has increased exponentially.
It begins with a glance, with a kind word, with a conversation, and pretty soon you've developed this relationship.
No family deserves to have this happen in their life. You're never the same. Never.
Real men do not prey upon defenseless and precious children. Knock it off, or we're coming for you. Oh. kill us or that which will destroy our children. We can't be a network of people that says no more by ourselves.
The stories are something that the general public will never even imagine could happen. As long as there is supply, demand, it will never end.
Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, one of the greatest hunters in the child minor sex trafficking world, Craig Sawyer.
Question for you. I want you to ask yourself, what is it on this earth that's more precious to you than your own life? You don't even have to tell me what it is. I just want to see a show of hands if you know what that is or who that is. Okay, thank you. On March 10th, 2017, our daughter Aspen walked out of a Subway sandwich shop in Tucson. And a serial rapist who should have still been in prison kept getting let back out. He had a warrant on him for over 2 months. He should have been in prison, not on the streets. He walked up to our daughter, he put a knife to her side, he put his arm around her, and he led her into a nightmare that I won't try to describe to you here. I got a call, or I got woken up because my wife got a call from Aspen in the middle of the night, and I was woken up by Tressa, my wife. She was crying. She said, "Baby, it's Aspen. She's been raped." And now I'm spinning. Now I'm waking up. I'm like, who all dies? Who, what, who? Show them to me. Where do I need to go to safeguard my baby girl? Yep. And I'm thinking, okay, I'm not in Baghdad. I'm not in Beirut. I'm not in Sarajevo. Where am I? Okay, I'm in Tucson, Arizona. What can I do? Where is she, babe? Give me cross streets. What street is she on? Where is she coming? Because Tressa says she's on her way home, but I could hear my baby girl screaming through the phone. She was hysterical. Absolutely hysterical. Screaming. And she was coming home. So I got on the phone and I had Aspen vector her in. I was calling the sheriff's department to get them to intervene because I knew that she was still on the other side of town and that the sheriff's department could probably intersect her from their patrols sooner than I could get to her and make her safe until I could arrive there. Well, she got home before they intercepted her. We already had the sheriff's department at our house. And we got our baby girl back alive. We were fortunate. We were fortunate. Not everyone gets that. Not everyone gets that blessing or that luxury. We did. And long story short, our daughter decided, rather than us insulating her from it and pushing her away from the problem and trying to make it go away, she decided that she wanted to go through the pain and the agony and the humiliation of fighting back. And let me tell you, it's not easy. So she made the decision to fight back, and it was a brave decision because we told her about all the questioning they were going to do and all the physical exams that they were going to do and all the samples they had to take and on and on and on. And she said, "Oh, Papa, this is on the drive to the hospital before the sun even came up. I got to fight back. He can't be allowed to do this anymore." And I want you to know that I was very composed. I was very composed. I said, "You know what, Aspen, that's a very responsible decision. We'll back you in that 100%. Inside, folks, I want you to know, in honesty, I was like, yes, my baby girl, you go get him, you scrappy thing. We're going to take this guy down and he's going to rape no more." And as a family, we did. It took 2.5 years to bring that. And though they caught him, thank you, TPD, they caught him pretty soon because I offered to catch him for them. They hurried up and they got him. But it took 2.5 years to bring him to trial. And each time they were calling us and delaying the trial because he was allowed to go through 14 public defenders. And he kept firing his own public defenders. And every time they would call us Teresa would tell our daughter, Aspen, your trial's been delayed again because the scumbag's firing his lawyers, and it was re-traumatizing our daughter. So pretty soon, Aspen, or Teresa figured out to quit telling Aspen about the buffoonery of the court system. She just told her nothing, and we just loved on our daughter. So during this time, our daughter's counselor, and my own wife, and my teammates, and investigators all conspired against me and said, Craig, Aspen should be able to serve as a junior decoy agent in your operation so that she can fight back. And I'm like, no. My daughter doesn't go around against anywhere near creepers ever again. And my daughter, she looked right through me. She said, Papa, I'm going to do this with or without you. And I knew she meant it. My wife's Irish Cherokee, and Travis told you a little bit about my background so you could understand she means it. And so I thought, okay, if you're going to do this, baby girl, you're going to do this under your papa's wing where I can make you safe. I'm going to check your little body armor, and you're going to be in the room with me. We're going to have a SWAT team in the next room, canine unit, everything. We'll do this, but we'll do this my way. And she's like, that's right. Good answer, Papa. So she did, and she worked on an operation where we put 9 predators away in Utah. Travis is talking about a warrior. That little baby girl's a warrior. She's a warrior. That's what a warrior is. Someone who stands up and says, this can't be allowed to happen anymore. I'm going to do everything that I can. Right? Travis is right. You don't need battle armor to do that, although she did have type of battle armor on for safety. But it's the concept. You can fight back online. You can fight back with your votes. You can fight back with your voice and with your media. And we all must now. So we founded Veterans for Child Rescue. The next month after our baby girl was raped, the official documentation came in, and we founded Veterans for Child Rescue in order to fight back. And we filmed Contraland. It took us 3 years to film it. And the whole nightmare of bringing it to the people and all the gatekeepers and those that tried to subvert and undermine that good faith effort, that's a whole different story that should be a book or a movie all in its own. But God was on our side. He meant for the populace to be alerted, and that's what we did. Vets for Child Rescue's mission is to expose and eradicate child trafficking. So we make documentaries. Contraland's our first one. We're going to keep running more operations and taking these predators off the street and putting them in boxes where they can rape no more. And we're just going to grow it bigger and bigger and bigger. My brother Jakob Bouyans is going to be speaking here shortly. You're not going to want to miss that. God's got his hand on that man. We are becoming brothers. And there's going to be great things together. I don't know if you've seen his movie 8 Days yet, but it's a powerful film as well. I don't want to steal his thunder. I'm going to shut up, but just hold on for my brother here. He's coming. So we have a silent epidemic, though, in this country. We've already talked about the media. It's silent. We don't know about it. I was angered when I learned about it 6 years ago. Travis was angered about it when he learned about it. I was talking to grown men. They're like, I got ticked off because why wasn't I told that our children are being hunted? I've operated in 60 countries around the world now for God and country. And meanwhile, the predators that I thought I was trying to keep from coming here have already been operating here for decades. It's just been kept an ungodly secret. So ripping the lid off of that, folks, I think is the biggest thing we can all do. Ignite 320 million patriots to say, this ends now. This is the year. No more. There's a campaign of ideological subversion that's part of this media deceit and this suppression and this ignition of this hate between different groups to divide us and conquer us and weaken us and shatter us and cause our country to be destabilized for hostile foreign takeover so that we lose all of our freedoms and liberties. And this child trafficking thing is being run by a lot of the same evil scumbags that are doing this to all of us. So waking up to it is very important. So I'm grateful for these events. It traumatizes the little children's minds. A lot of them are being kept in dog kennels. I know of actual cases where they're being kept in dog kennels, only to be brought out and raped and put back in. Folks, no human should be treated that way. That's not what life is supposed to be like. It's not supposed to happen. We can't let this go on, right? Let's use our voices against that. They torture them, they murder them when they're done because they don't want to get caught. There are people in Mexico that'll buy them, send them down there when they age out, and they finish them off. Sometimes in ritual ceremonies, sometimes not. It's all bad. These people are sick, it needs to end. So when does a nightmare become a blessing? When you get your heart broken and you get ticked off from it and you take action.
That's
and that
right.
action changes it.
That's
and ends
right.
the evil.
CPS. That's right, CPS, DCS.
So I would
right.
say that a nightmare becomes a blessing when God intervenes and helps you turn tragedy into triumph. This is the time for that. So it's okay to sit down and cry when your heart's broken. But don't stay there. If you're seeking direction, it's okay to kneel down and pray and say, God, help me. Help me understand what to do about this, because this is not okay.
It is not okay.
And then once you've got your direction and your marching orders, you stand up and you act, because now you've got a mission. That's what we need to do, people. Sit down and pray. Kneel down and cry. Stand up and act. Rise with us and let's end child trafficking in the United States. God bless you. Thank you.
Where's our governor? Where's Cindy McCain? Where's the Human Trafficking Council? Not here.
Craig, you got me emotional, man. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you for not only fighting for our country, but thank you for fighting for your family. Thank you for fighting for the children. And just thank you for being you. God bless you and your family, Craig. Guys, louder. I want him to hear his neighbor from Tucson. Louder. Thank you, Craig. 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 Thank you, Craig.
Thank you, Craig.
May God allow us to be the warrior that man is. I'll tell you that much. Amen.
Amen.
Coming up to sing, I just told her, I said, she's got the vocals of Christina Aguilera at 30 old. She's the one, the only, that Roosevelt sings. Someone that's become a friend, her family's become friends. Guys, when I tell you that it doesn't matter your age, it doesn't matter what part you're in your life. You can be a warrior at 6 years old. You can be a warrior at 95 years old, which is why I said we needed 50,000 people out here. And mark my words, we will have 50,000 people out here. And it doesn't matter your age. And that's why I admire your family. And her family backs her very strongly, guys. And if there's parents, I appreciate these people because they try to understand their. They know she has a beautiful voice, but it's about what she needs, not what they can make out of her. And that's where I said it starts at home. So I'm excited to announce Roosevelt Singh coming up. This gal has been a child help ambassador. She's currently raising $1 million for abused children using her voice. Woo! 13 years old, I think I was playing basketball in the streets, and here she is saving kids from the streets. That's amazing. Her hashtag that she uses is 5 too many. She'll give you a little rundown on that. But guys, please welcome to the stage the one, the only, Roosevelt Sings.
Thank you guys all for coming out. It means so, so much to me and rising up for the children. You guys are amazing. Thank you so, so much for rising up for the children. You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we can walk it out and move. mountains. We can walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up high like the waves. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you.
Are all here and standing up for children. This is a big thing that is being silenced, and thank you guys for being a voice for the voiceless. And I have started my own campaign called hashtag five too many. It's where you put a heart in your hand in a stop position to stop five kids from dying every single day because of child abuse and neglect, and that is five too many. And I have an event coming up September 26th. Woo! It's called The Music and the Message, supporting Child Help and Operation Underground Railroad. Tim Ballard, the founder, will be there speaking live. It's going to be amazing, so you can go to Roosevelt Sings, my Instagram. The link is in my bio to go buy your tickets. All of the money does go to Child Help and Operation Underground Railroad. And I'm just really excited, so go get your tickets, and I'd love to see you guys there. Okay, so I have one more song. It's called Trust in You by Lauren Daigle. I love this song. It is so close to my heart because I know that through everything that is going on in our world today, that we can trust in God, and that is the thing that we need to do. So, thank you guys.
Thank you.
changes what you see. I've tried to win this war, I confess. My hands are weary, I need your rest. Mighty warrior, king of the fight. No matter what I face, you're by my side. When you don't move the mountains, I needed you to move. When you don't part the waters, I wish I could walk through. When you don't give the answers, as I cry out to you, I will trust, I will trust, I will trust in you. Truth is, you know what tomorrow brings. There's not a day that you have not seen. So in all things be my life and breath. I want what you want, Lord, and nothing less.
I know it's hot, and I know that it's been a long day from work and everything, but thank you so, so much for coming out tonight and standing up for the children. We need to know, we need to make ourselves be heard to stand up for these children and make abuse and neglect and everything that is going on to these innocent children stop. So thank you so, so much. You guys are amazing.
I know. Lawrence, the child help thing is disturbing. Because from what we've learned about child help in the past, it's definitely worth.
Come on, guys.
Oh my lord, we gotta figure out what's going up with child help.
Come on, guys. Let's hear a fan voice. Wow, 13 years old and got me crying over here. You know, God bless you, Roosevelt. Hey, do me a favor, guys.
Whoa,
Opa. Where I come from, we say Opa. Never. I think you guys all know this motto. They always say it's not the people, well, it's usually not the people closest to you that end up supporting you. You open up a business and it's usually not those people. And you always have random strangers that come out and it really exposes. And as you grow in life, your circle becomes smaller.
I can put my political views
so
on here.
As we look here, as we look at the whole, like Travis Haley said, this is our whole. So I'm asking you guys to do a favor, and I genuinely mean this, okay? This young girl is growing herself. She's doing an amazing cause. I need you all to go on Instagram. Opa. Hello. Can you hear me now? This isn't the Verizon wireless commercial, can you hear me? Yep. Can you hear me or no? I can yell.
We all know that Greg McKay went to child help, which is a problem.
Do me a favor, listen, we're a whole. We've united as a whole. We are one, okay? So I think you know where I'm going with this. pull out your phones, and I'm asking you to do this now, and support her. Go follow her on Instagram. Go share her songs. And I mean that wholeheartedly. We need to build people like her and not celebrate the chaos in Hollywood that seem to make it from doing wrong things. Come on, guys, louder than that. We know we can louder. She needs the love and support, and I expect each and every one of you guys to get out there and to tag her and to share, because that's how it works. And let me tell you guys something. The algorithm isn't built for you guys. Her Instagram is Roosevelt Sings. Roosevelt with one O. Roosevelt_Sings. Underscore Sings. Roosevelt Sings. So please go follow her. Now, real quick to get to social media. We all know the algorithm isn't built for us, okay? We know the algorithm is not built to help the children. We know that Facebook and Instagram don't want to take down the pedophile pages, and they seem to have some sort of kick for pedophiles on their platforms. So what I'm telling you is, when we got to support one of our own, and we got to tag them to beat that algorithm, and we got to continue going, that is the fight, that is the war, that's us. Okay, guys, it's not just like hoorah, hooray, walk out of here. It's when you see her share a post, you like it, you comment, it helps us grow. That's how we connect. If you see somebody and they post something good and you're just jealous of it, like it, I don't care. Because when you help their engagement, we are fighting a fight. We need the, when you go to something, you're like, wow, that's a great post. 3 comments and 43 likes, and they have 3,000 followers. What? Why aren't we supporting our own? To stand for each other when we come across one another. Share that. Share Sawman stuff. Share Dragonfly stuff. Share Roosevelt stuff. Share Chris's stuff. Everybody needs to share. And guys, we will, like Craig said, we will beat pedophilia and child abuse here in America, and we're going to get to that. So out of social media into the fake news, I will say, I'm going to give a shout out here, guys, and I want this to be said, because look, I'm not one of those where I'm going to sit here and be a pessimist and put people down. I think we need to build where we get wins. Life isn't about it's going to change tomorrow, it's all about the small wins. So Anita Roman from Fox 10 News, God bless you, I pray for you and your family. She was the first to reach out to me and said, hey, I want to get you on Fox 10, and she made sure the people showed up. So thank you, Anita Roman from Fox 10 News. It's people like you that help us change the world, so thank you very much. We appreciate you, Fox 10. Now, maybe the other networks can pick up after them and learn how to do their jobs. Don't get me started on that. Now, here's where we're at, guys. All this also moves forward in another direction. It's called legislation. Legislation is very powerful, okay? We see a lot of movements happening, yet the people don't focus on what really matters. Enforcing our local environments. That's making sure we have the right people in place to change city, state, and then national law.
Get Kate out.
No, we're focusing on local.
She writes bad legislation.
Here. We're talking about making a change
Kate
here.
Right. So with legislation that, that's high.
I had somebody said, "Hey, the senator wants
crime.
To be a part of something." I said, "Well, the senator can
get
call
Kate
me.
Brophy
okay?
McGee out. She's a handmaiden to the governor."
I've been asked to go to the Mike Pence rally. When people reach out and take a step to do something, that's who we'll work with. We're not going to sit there and beg people to be a part of child sex trafficking. And the guy that I'm going to bring up, he is fighting. He's running for Congress for the first time. He won the primary as a Republican candidate in his District 7, running as for congressman. He had 2,700 more votes than any other Republicans ever had for District 7. Guys, this man's a father, he's a fighter, he's a warrior, he's a business owner, and he's a man that's going to get the job done. And I want Josh Barnett to come up here and tell everybody how he's going to help us change America.
Marty Lynch.
I see a lot of signs out here.
Marty Lynch. Hey, Marty.
That say God wins.
Hey, Marty.
And I'm a believer. And I believe that God puts people in your path along the way. And when I first learned about sex trafficking and what was happening, I was sitting in Senator David Farnsworth's office, state senator, and I met a guy, Marty Lynch. I also met a friend of mine, David Jose, who's been fighting with sex trafficking, a lot of CPS-related issues.
Marty's the guy with the blue shirt
now,
over there.
I bring that up because, you know, we have a lack of due process. And what I mean by that is, you know, due process goes all the way back to the jury of the peers, back to the Magna Carta days, you know, in 1215, that far back. We have in our CPS and our foster care, DCS, whatever you want to call it around the country, but 88% of kids saved out of sex trafficking go through our foster care services. Not 8%, 88%. So what do we do about it? Why is that happening? One of the main things I saw after I dug into it and talked to people is that the lack of due process in our courts. In 2005, we used to have due process in what I call DCS or CPS courts.
Yes, Lear.
And back then,
Arizona is
87%
infiltrated.
Of the kids got returned home to their parents.
It's a mess here.
For stuff like Cheerios on the floor. I mean, literally that ridiculous.
Our state government
that they would
is
take
corrupt.
Kids from a home. Now, there are more legitimate reasons why we have CPS, right? Kids getting beat, you know, abused, et cetera, et cetera. But they took the juries out of these courts, and guess what the percentage is now that are returned back to their homes? 0.04%. So think about that. 0.04% have returned back. 87% when we had a jury of our peers. Now, why is this happening? Well, I believe that we have legislation that's been here in Arizona that's been tabled repeatedly, that was written by Martin Lynch, that's here right now. And you can look it up, and I encourage everybody to get involved and look it up. If you go to azledge.gov, you'll see a bill, SCR 1049. And what that is we're trying to install due process back in these courts. That's simple. Another one is SB 1677, and that has to do more with the family court system in general. Now, what do we do to fix this problem? What I see happening is that things are being monetarily incentivized from the top down. When you remove a kid, that DCS is getting $5,000 to $8,000 per kid per month.
And ASPA! Okay? Kids for cash!
Now,
and ASPA!
When you take kids out, and it's part of a corrupt, what I feel, a corrupt system.
It's corrupt!
Because when you involve money with our government, we all know how that works out normally.
Kids for cash!
You know, I believe that when you're going to remove a child from somebody's home, that's the most cherished thing in your life is your kid. And I don't feel a single person should be the one to decide whether that happens or not.
Give them back. Give us back our kids.
You know, I see stuff. You know, we have DCS workers in Arizona wearing pink t-shirts that say professional kidnappers on them.
No joke. They lie.
It's unacceptable.
They have immunity.
And I can't deal with what these warriors have done from that perspective.
No immunity.
But what I want to do is from a legislative standpoint to fix the problem. Yeah. To cut that conveyor belt off.
Sorry.
You know, 88% of the safe and sex trafficking. How do we fix that? We put due process back in court. It's that simple. The numbers show it from when we had it to now. So that's one thing we can do. And that bill that's in there, how many people here have called their legislator, the state legislator, the House representative, the state senator, and demanded that something be done? Has anybody, raise your hands, people that have called. Not very many.
All day, every day.
We can sit here and complain and rah-rah all we want, which is great, because it brings awareness, right, to the issue. But unless we address it with these people over here, it's not going to get fixed, period.
Where's our governor?
So you need to call your people, look up who your legislative, you know, in your legislative districts, your state representatives, call them, email them, harass them if you have to. Call your governor and tell them you want things changed. You want due process back in these courts. They've had this bill sitting there and they've tabled it, and it has to stop. Now, I'm gonna invite a friend up here real quick. Her name's Priscilla Marquez.
Oh.
Now, I don't know how many are familiar with her story. Here she comes.
Justice for Charisma. This is Charisma's mother.
So when I met her, I wish I never met you, because it would have been, everything would have been a lot better, right? But when I met her, and the reason why I met her is her daughter was taken, and family was taking care of him at the time, and they removed her from the family that was watching her and given to a foster home or a foster family. Well, I'll make a long story short, but her daughter, Charisma, right here, was murdered and put in an attic for 2 years. Now,
justice for Charisma!
What's for me, what's even worse is the fact that this same couple that adopted her, killed her, was in an attic for 2 years and nobody knew. They actually adopted another kid out during that time frame.
Corrupt. It's all corrupt.
And this is, again, there's so many different angles we can look at this. And I'm not saying, for me personally, you know, people say to get rid of DCS or we need to reform it. And the first thing
Shut it down.
Due process back in these courts. There's no reason, when I looked at the situation, her daughter should have been taken. I believe it was the uncle at the time that was watching her. But they removed her because they make money. And that's what it comes down to.
And ASPA. And ASPA.
So I just wanted to introduce her and because I want to keep her story alive. Okay? And I know it's a difficult story. We were there from kind of when it happened.
Justice for Charisma!
It struck me, you know, my heart, my team's heart. We were there basically like the day after almost, I believe, or darn close, you know. And I just want to keep that story alive because this little girl is a prime example of why we need reform in our system, not just here, but around the country. But it's going to take us, everybody together, reaching out to
your
legislators saying enough is enough. Okay?
Justice for Charisma.
We have legislation that can help, you know, maybe not fix it 100%, but it's going to make a big difference. And we need this passed. So I need you to look up these bills on azledge.gov and call and demand that these be heard and voted on. Yes. The bill is SCR 1049 and SB 1677. Okay. Now, another thing, you know, we have, you know, luckily how I look at it, and I know I don't want to get too political, but you know, we have a president now who's fighting pedophilia like never before. And like I said, when I see all these signs that, you know, God wins and God can, you know, follow his path. And I see another side that says, leaves under God out of the Pledge of Allegiance. You know, what you do is you call your legislators, you let them know we demand this, and let everybody else know that you demand this. Get these bills, put them on your social media, and get these people to quit tabling these and actually vote on them, okay? And just one last thing, outside of that, I'm gonna keep these updated bills on my website. It's barnettforaz.com. We're gonna keep them updated on there so you can look, just pull it up, we'll have a link, just click on it, it'll take you right to them. And we're gonna keep any updates on there as well. And also a story involving hers, because I wanna keep this memory alive because this cannot happen ever again. So thank you very much, and I appreciate everybody showing up tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Josh. Woo-hoo!
God bless you, Priscilla. Thank you, Josh. We appreciate you. Thank you guys for being patient here. I'm really excited to bring up our last and final speaker, somebody that's also becoming a brother to me here, just recently introduced from my friend Erica. This guy, just from speaking to him, has helped change my life. I had a great afternoon with him today. Yako's been somebody that's been fighting this fight for 26 years, guys. Longer than a lot of you in the crowd have been alive. 26 years. He's somebody that's been in the trenches and understands what's going on. Yako has fought in 53 different countries across the world. 53. He's had his foot in 53 feet in 53 different countries. This is a man that stands for the children, a man that's advocating, a man that's changing legislation, that's consulting, that's helping, that's pushing, that's speaking. And honestly, a lot of you guys saw, I had him on, he was going from back-to-back marches, that Thursday to Saturday, that's why he couldn't be here Friday, and he was just drained out. So I want you guys to check out, I'm going to show you his future film, 8 Days. We have a little expose of his future film, 8 Days.
Hey Reed, come say hi to Trafficking didn't really exist. important that we know who Amber hangs out with. We just always want to make sure that she's safe.
Gosh, I didn't even know you were friends with them.
This is Tyler. He's gonna be our driver tonight.
I was hoping that you could come with me. I don't know, I'm having a little fun, huh?
We'll blame it on the wind.
She has never done this before.
If she hasn't turned up by tomorrow, we'll file the paperwork. And we'll start a search.
I'm Heather Hayes. As you know, we've been following the heartbreaking story of missing teenager Amber Stevens.
You heal. Because I let you heal.
No one ever wakes up thinking they'll be kidnapped. This shouldn't happen here. Darkness. Monsters. I can't close my eyes or cover my ears anymore.
I got nothing from the text.
You said it would be okay. What are you doing this? Where are you taking me?
I didn't know what was going to happen to her.
My child.
Please help me. We can go together. Every life is worth saving.
Drew is life.
It's your last chance.
I'll kill you and your family.
We're gonna find her. We're gonna find her.
Guys, it's my honor to bring up the one, the only, the man, the myth, the legend, Jakob Bouyans. Yeah! Let him hear it in Dallas. That's where he's from. He flew in from Dallas this morning.
Craig, you're a champ, bro. Love you. Love your wife. Thank you, Adele, and all the organizers. All our armed forces, our security detail, all the men and women that have served, we honor you. I can't do it without you. It's impossible to do it without you. So God bless you. You've got a problem tonight. You've got a real problem. One day a guy named Joshua stands next to a river. And he says, God, I'm ready for the fight. I got an army of 10,000. And God says, no, you don't. Tell him to drink water. Look at who grabs at it and look who's patient with an open hand. He says, God, there's 300 in open hand. He said, that's your army. Send the rest home. That's a fact. That's a true story. So you got a question in your heart tonight, because I don't care whether you like me or not. That's irrelevant. I don't care for your likes. I want to know what's happening in your chest. Yes. I want to know, are you going to be the 300 or the 9,700 that gets sent home? I care less about you showing up tonight, because we're at the river. So you've got a problem. You showed up, maybe not knowing what you're signing up for. It happens. Craig will tell you. They drop like flies in the SEAL team school. I want to be a SEAL. And then they see what it takes and they say, I'm going to go home. So this is you and God. Because these people don't go home with you. You don't have flashing lights in the morning and someone singing the Star Spangled Banner and a 13-year-old wowing you with a song and Navy SEALs inspiring you when you wake up tomorrow morning. When you wake up tomorrow morning, it's a gut check moment. It's a moment of, am I willing to fight and storm the hill by myself? So you've got a problem. Because you can lie to me. You can lie to Craig. You can lie to Adele. But I promise you, when you lay your head on your pillow, those thoughts are real.
and you cannot lie to yourself. They will haunt you. That's where this battle is being won. Inside your chest tonight. Because let me tell you something. You want to fight child sex trafficking?
Yeah.
Let me share something with you real quick. Maybe you've never been asked this question. This is the part where you maybe don't like me. But hey, my kids and my wife love me, so I'm good. I'm loved by an almighty creator. I'm his son. So this is the question you got to ask yourself. Are you willing, each and every one of you, from this little young man who I want to give a five because you're a champion. I've watched you with your mom. I've watched you, brother. You protect that woman. You got to ask yourself a question right now. And I'm asking you, and I'm serious. Are you contributing to child sex trafficking?
AZDCS,
and you may say,
State
you crazy.
Bar and well, Family Court.
It. I'm going to ask you again. Are you, I ask this question in churches. Are you, Craig, I'm asking you. You check yourself. If you're not willing to ask yourself, am I contributing to this issue? You're not really here to fight. Let me tell you why. What makes you think you can fight child sex trafficking out there if you can't fight it in here? If you can't fight it in your home, in your neighbor, on your street, on your school board, in your city, in your zip code, in your state? So I'm asking you again, are you contributing to child sex trafficking? Ask yourself the question.
But y'all quite
don't know what to ask.
DCS?
Well, let me help you.
CPS.
Do you watch porn?
State attorneys.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Prosecutors.
Do you watch porn?
GALs.
Because if you watch porn, you're feeding child sex trafficking. 100%. 100%. Don't disconnect. You're not the radicals that set buildings on fire. You're the rational. Connect with me. You cannot stand here tonight. You cannot hold that sign up and contribute to the problem. This is a Kairos moment. This is a moment, literally, where you either drink like this or you drink like this. This is a moment where you either under God's covering in this fight or you walk out on your own and you will be picked off like a man on the hill, I promise you. So you got to go home tonight. Second thing, husbands, do you honor your wife? Because if you don't honor your wife, you're contributing to the problem. If you degrade a woman, if you break her down, if you speak in a derogatory fashion, if you don't honor women, if you allow your sons to let boys be boys, then you're adding to the problem. People ask me every day, Yaku, we want to help you. I say, okay, stop watching porn. And you hear the brakes hit. No, I want to go find predators. I said, I want to make sure you're not one of them. I want to make sure you're not abusing your child. I want to make sure your wife looks at you and say, this is a man that's a watchman. That's for watchmen. I'm looking for those who God says my spirit goes to and fro to find one. Because I will leave 99 to go after one. You cannot, in this fight that I've been in for 26 years, be a hypocrite. It doesn't fly. So this is a big moment for you tonight. This is a huge moment because if you choose right, the righteousness and the favor and the protection and the anointing and the blessing you walk under, you can't measure. You don't understand what you're able to do in the city. Forget about fighting Washington, D.C. How about you protect Phoenix?
Yes.
How about Adele, I challenge you. How about you're the first movement that said, not in my city. Eradicate it in Phoenix. Then go to your neighboring state, California. Do you understand that I didn't read a book? I didn't watch a movie. I didn't get enlightened through a friend. No, I woke up one morning as an 18-year-old, 1994, as a senior in high school, and realized my 13-year-old sister is gone. Single mom, no dad. 6 years, my sister, two brothers, one sister. I'm the oldest. I'm the dad in the house because there's no dad. 6 years, Ilanka, my sister, was trafficked. We didn't know she was trafficked. She was just gone. There was no such thing as child sex trafficking talk in 1994. She was a problem child, a runaway, but she was not. This is a close-knit family, doing Bible study in our mom's bed at night. Tight. We're still tight today. 6 years. I did not see my mom one day, one second, 1 hour, 1 minute say, she's gone. She said, God's got her. She'll come back. And when she comes back, we're immigrating to the land of the free. So I get to the land of the free, 2001, 3 weeks after 9/11, by God's grace, a united America. America that says this is a safe place. One nation, under God, liberty, justice for all. And then I find child sex trafficking in Chattanooga, Tennessee. And my world is rocked. Because we brought our sister out of the miry clay to the land of the free. And I find out and learn over a course of 10 years. And you hear me when I say this today. We are the leading nation on the face of the earth commercializing sex with children. Not China. I love Tim Ballard's work, but not Cambodia, not Indonesia, not Haiti, not the Dominican Republic, not the Middle East. These 50 states of the United States of America. Why? 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 Does child sex trafficking flourish in our society? Because we from Alfred Kinsey, and then in the 1960s, embraced a sexually immoral culture, and we're normalizing an immoral society. You have to understand, as we're standing here today, if your child is in a public school, hear me, this should make your spine tingle. If your child is in a public school in your state, the CSE curriculum is being taught. It's not mandated yet, but it will go to your Senate floor for a vote. That child sexual exploitation is in the classroom. They're grooming children in the classroom. This is a fact. Go watch the expose. You have to understand, the only way you break the United States of America, you cannot break us with military force. I served my country. I would have given anything to serve this country, my new country. 15 years I've been a citizen, but these boys cannot be defeated on the battleground. You can't break this nation in military action. The only way you break this nation, according to Adolf Hitler, is what? You corrupt the youth. You go after the children. You have to understand, these are not random guys running around. This is very programmatic. It's very coordinated. It's a targeted attack towards the youth, because if you can break a child sexually, you have a zombie in their 20s that will be completely dependent on government. You have an individual that could barely get by, never mind fight. You've got an individual that now only fights for safety and forfeits freedom. Do you understand how this works? The ultimate agenda, this is in 27 states in the United States. It will be in all 50 if we don't stop it. They're voting on it in Texas next Thursday. It's flying through the bills. The last vote went through 1 o'clock in the morning on March 27th when you were in lockdown in Washington State. 1 o'clock in the morning when no parents could show up. Governor Inslee voted it into law that every child in Washington will be taught in kindergarten about masturbation, in kindergarten about anal sex. You have to understand. So as it was shared with you right now about bills, you need to go look at AB 2218 California. AB 2218. And you need to go learn what's happening in the school system. And you need to call your state school board. And you need to call your principal. And you square off with your principal. And you ask the principal, do we teach CSE? in this school? And if the answer is yes, you've got a snake in the hen house.
I know, right, Tanner?
Listen to me today. Listen to me.
If you haven't shared,
you go to your pastor.
Share it.
Pastors that are in the room, I'm ordained. I love you. God bless you. But unless you use that pulpit to preach the full gospel, get off the pulpit. You go ask your pastor, are you, with respect, leader of this flock, going to talk about child sex trafficking in this church? Are you going to lock these doors and call the men up, not out, and say, deal with your sexual immorality because you're part of the problem? Are you going to call the men up to champion the women as queens in the kingdom? And are you going to call the women up to champion the men and stop emasculating men in this country, by the way? I come from a different place. We deal with things a little different, Craig, in Africa. I'll tell you a quick story. It works like this in South Africa. You hear fight, fight, fight at recess. You walk over, there's a beautiful circle. There's one teacher watching and two guys for about 25 seconds square up. And it's a fair fight until someone else jumps in and then they stop the fight. And a fight never lasts longer than 15 seconds. And those two guys become brothers. That's how we deal with things in Africa. I'm not promoting violence. I'm just letting you know, where are the men? Where are the warriors? Where are the watchmen? Where are the guys that want to defend all women, not just your women? Adele, you don't have kids yet, but you're defending other men's children. You want to know how you win this fight? It is impossible to win this fight by just arresting all the pimps. We took El Chapo. The guy that was behind him thanked us. Thank you, now I'm in charge. You got to curb demand. And you curb demand in the people. And you fight this fight in the people. This is not a fight law enforcement will win. Law enforcement is to support the people. This is a fight you fight in your school, but you start in your home. Dad, listen to me. This man with this pink shirt, I just have a feeling. Are you a father? Your kids are older, right? I'm asking you, man to man. You call your kids tonight. You call them tonight. I don't care what that relationship looks like. I don't care if it's broken. You put your pride in your pocket and you call your girl. Do you have girls? You have boys? You call your boys tonight on the way home and you say, son, I have a conversation with you. Are you dealing with sexual immorality? And if he says yes, you stand with that dude. You walk him through it. If he says no, then you say, then make a commitment with me tonight that you're going to fight on your street for every child on that street. That's every dad. Every dad. You make the effort to pour into your children. You make the effort to make sure that a 12-year-old girl knows she's loved by her father and she doesn't get it from a creep online. You make the effort. COVID did not do us favors. COVID removed the pimp. COVID gave the buyer direct access to the child. They're grooming kids in the classroom. They want to lower the age consent in our country to 12. They want to normalize pedophilia as a sexual preference. This is a fact. So do not fall in the camp where you want to go fight a fight on the other side of the train tracks, but it's broken in your house. Women, if you're married, mom, you are. That guy that's walking around here with your kids, that you call husband, tomorrow morning when he wakes up, I'm asking you to say the following. Actually, I'm asking you to take your lipstick tonight. And I want you to go, all women, and you go right on his mirror where he shaves, man of God. You go do that. And if you tell me, well, my husband's not a man of God, then you call it out of him. Every morning you tell him, man of God, warrior, protector of the children, watchman on the wall. That's how you raise a nation. You tell this young kid every day, you're a watchman. Mom, what does that mean? You're going to protect every girl in your school. Anytime anybody comes against a woman, you defend. That's how you raise and you counter what they're doing. So my sister was rescued 6 years in. by God's grace. Today, she's a warrior. She's the best case I've ever seen. I want you to understand, when you look in the eyes of a victim that became a survivor, the person that was trafficked that left is not the person that comes home. It's a shell. The lifespan is 7 years. That's it. They die. Suicide is through the roof. Drug addiction, murder. Everything Craig has told you is true. Cages, tunnels, but here's the deal. The fastest rising form of sex trafficking in the United States of America, and it rose 1,026% in 2018 and 2019, is sex trafficking called familial trafficking. Families trafficking their own children. Then I ask, where's the neighbors? Because if the neighbor would come to this guy and speak to him, trust me, when you look a guy square in the eye and you go, are you dealing with sexual immorality? There's a reaction. And when you ask him, will you fight against child sex trafficking? Learn how to read people. Go to our website. Go to Craig's site. Learn how to spot a child that's in danger in 30 seconds in the 7-Eleven. Last year, I personally trained 100 FBI special agents. In the first training session, not one of them in 5 minutes could identify a child who's being exploited. Not to their fault, they're not trained to do that. They're trained to interrogate and break someone down over hours. You don't have hours. And then after a couple quick training sessions, that group in North Carolina started arresting pimp and pedophile after pedophile after pedophile. And you realize it's under your nose. I'm over my time, so I owe Adele.
You don't mean
nothing. Keep going.
I'm gonna pray over you tonight. I'm going to pray a righteous prayer over you. I'm going to pray a warrior's prayer over you. I'm going to speak a father's blessing over you. For the guys in this crowd that has a father wound, your dad abandoned you. Your dad abused you. Okay? I can introduce you to a dad that doesn't do that. And you go be a dad that does not do that. You may be a product of your environment, but you can walk out of that environment. If you're a woman today and a man's touched you inappropriately, let me show you something. I want to show you something. You do not raise your hand. Men, I'm going to speak to you. You do not raise your freaking hand right now if this doesn't come from the deepest part of your soul. Because you will lie to yourself and it's going to eat you for the next 5 months. I'm asking you a question. I want a declaration. When he hung on a tree, he hung in public. I want a declaration. If right now something's happening in your chest and you're a man, if something's sparking inside, you say, damn it, I want to be a better husband. Man, I want to honor my wife. Man, I want to build my wife. Man, I want to love my daughters. Man, I want to tell my son, rise up, dude, and be a defender. If you're that guy, and you do not raise your freaking hand, but if you're that guy, then raise your hand. Keep your hand up. Keep your hand up for the young girls in the crowd, the unmarried women in the crowd. I want you to see there are good guys in this country. There are fighters in this country. There are warriors in this country. Thank you, guys. So change your mind, woman. Pray for men to rise up in this country. Pray for men who are fighters to go storm the hill and do it in love, but do it with justice and righteousness. And in women, you're a mom. Get in touch with your intuition. Train your eyes. Train your ears. Train your mind. You're the most powerful force. I am blessed to serve on a trafficking council with the White House. It's such a blessing. Praise Jesus. Okay? But, I'll tell you that, this is the first administration that fights this fight in any country, in any world. But I want to tell you this, mama. You're the most powerful person in this country, not the President of the United States. Because you have play dates. You see other mama's children. If you train your eyes, you can defend a child whose parents can't defend him or her in your house, in your neighborhood. You don't have to go to Washington, D.C. I'm talking about take your street back. So I expect you to go see every neighbor on your street and tell them, hey, by the way, way, our family fights child sex trafficking, just need you to know. And if they move a month later, you had a pedophile on your street. Fight first at home, and then we can go take the bigger cities, okay? Let me pray for you. Lord Father, I say thank you for the Gideon's 300. I pray a father's blessing over these people. I pray, Lord, whether they know you or not, they're yours. Whether they've ever cried out to you or not, you love them unconditionally. Black, white, Hispanic, Latino, Native American, I don't care if they're a Smurf, God, you love them. You love them equally, united. I pray that you bless this body of people, that you weaponize them with truth, that you set them free first of their own iniquities, their own challenges, their own burdens, and that you send them to this nation called Phoenix and Arizona, Lord, that you protect their families and their children, their vehicles, that you bless them financially, that you prosper them, that you touch their hands, whatever they touch may it turn to gold, to your glory, in Jesus' name, and I honor and respect you. Thank you so much. You're warriors. Amen. Thank you.
Everybody, let's hear him in Dallas, Texas, where he's from. Yako, thank you for being the change the world wishes to see. Thank you for fighting. Thank you, Craig. Thank you, Travis. Thank you to every warrior that's been out here tonight. Thank you for being you. Guys, their future starts tonight. God has blessed us with 8/29, August 29th. Their future starts tonight. I love you all. Get home safe. There's a storm coming in, so we're going to cut the march short, try to take some pictures, but we're going to have to end it here, guys, because there's a march coming in, so we're going to get out. I love you all. We'll be in touch soon. Take care of the children. God bless.